Good evening, Mr. Winston. Please come. Well, before starting, Mr. Winston, I would like you to know that this is a completely secure private area. So, don't worry, anything you say will remain strictly between us two. So just to start us off and to warm you up and ease you into it, we'll just be asking you some simple questions, so if you could please answer them. If you don't mind, can you please state your full name?
Winston. Winston Smith.
And how old are you?
I think I'm 39 years old.
You believe that you're 39?
I'm not 100% sure, but I believe so.
And where do you live?
In Oceania.
What's it like in Oceania?
Cold. Oceania is very cold.
Anything else?
And also gray. Except for,
Except for what, Winston?
Except for the pictures. The giant pictures of Big Brother.
Are they placed, everywhere?
Yes. They're the only thing that stands out. Everything else is colorless and bland. Except for those pictures.
If you don't mind, could you please describe these pictures? What are they like?
It was one of those pictures that are so contrived that the eyes follow you about when you move. Big Brother is watching you, the captain beneath the ramp. Over time, it starts getting to your head. You start to believe that maybe he is watching you. Maybe he is looking at every single one of your movements. I started becoming paranoid. Every single one of my actions throughout the day were carefully made, because I always had the fear that through the telescreens and cameras that he was watching. And even if there weren't any telescreens or cameras around to be seen, there was always the fear that there were tiny microphones placed in odd locations to pick up whatever you had to say.
Did you have any interactions with anyone, any conversations with anyone in society that you might recall?
Well, I talked to a few people, but it was all about the same thing. We either talked about razor blades, Big Brother himself, his party in sock, or the new words that were put in Newspeak, how they had replaced old words with new words. That's about it. It was just a never-ending cycle of the same boring conversations.
Any public gatherings?
No. Not really. Wait. There was this one public gathering that happened quite often.
Go on.
It was called the 2-Minute Hate. You could think of it as a routine initiation. It was a constant reminder to everyone to show them what they hated and what they loved. During the 2-Minute Hate, they would show the picture of Goldstein. He was someone that had openly denounced Big Brother. He believed in all types of freedom and thought that we should be free to make our own choices and live our lives accordingly. They all hated him. Every single one of them. They would gather in a big room and sit side by side to each other, facing the big screen. And they all just shouted and screamed when they saw him. Just pure, pure hate for 2 minutes.
Well, I'm glad that you mentioned the 2 minute hate. We actually had one of our doctors keep an eye on you for a specific amount of time, and one of the events that he recalled was the 2 minute hate, and he was monitoring you during that 2 minute, and this is his report that he had sent me, and I will read it out to you. He says, in a lucid moment, Winston found that he was shouting with the others and kicking his knees violently against the rug of his chair.
The horrible thing about the 2 minute hate was that one was not obliged to act a part, but that it was impossible to avoid joining it. They made the 2 minute hate into a natural human instinct. I guess I had no control over what I was saying, or my actions physically or mentally. You don't realize that you're doing something when it becomes routine. It just becomes something that's a part of you. You just join in with the rest of the crowd, not thinking at all.
Well, what about the past? History books and other means that might tell people that what is happening in society in Oceania, it's wrong.
You're right. But there isn't anything to look at from the past. Who controls the past, ran the party's slogan, controls the future. Who controls the present controls the past. And yet the past, though of its nature alterable, never had been altered. Whatever was true now was true from everlasting to everlasting.
Well, I believe that we have made some great progress during this session. Shall I book you for next week, same time?
Sure. Thanks a lot, Doc. See you next week.
Alright, see you later, Winston. Thank you.